Hi everyone and welcome back. So today I'm going to talk about diets. Yes, not dieting per se. I'm not going to give you gyan on, you know, kya diet hai, kya karna chahiye, kya nahi karna chahiye, what's good for you, what's not good for you. But I thought I'll come and talk to you guys about three specific diets which have become lifestyle diets for most of the people. And these three diets are the most common diets, most popular ones. You know, why I say that these have become lifestyle diets is because, you know, there are something called crash course diets, jo log karte hai to attain a certain kind of a goal in a very short span of time or in a, you know, distinguished set of time. But these diets have become a lifestyle. So when you choose to, like, there are people who have chosen to continue with their lives with these diets for a very, very long period of time. So yes, let's get straight to it. And before we do that, just a word of caution, guys, I am not a certified trained nutritionist. So all that I'm saying is what I've studied from my training courses and my experience. I'm not here suggesting you guys to what to try with, or, you know, kaunsa diet achha hai, kaunsa diet achha nahi hai. Sare diets ke apne pros and cons hote hai. So I'm not here to do that. All I'm here to do is make you guys aware and inform you guys ki this is what's happening, and, you know, you can choose, guys. So you can choose. Anyway, so let's get straight to it. So first diet that I want to talk to you guys about is the ketosis diet. Yes, the keto diet. I mean, when this diet came, a lot of people around us wanted to do it. The actors, the athletes, the common people. Now, what is ketosis diet? So it involves food with high amounts of fat, considerable amount of proteins, and very low amounts of carbohydrates. Now, this is a sort of, a my personal opinion, a sort of a complete no for people who are into workouts like weightlifting, strength and conditioning, CrossFit formats, or like a high endurance workout athletes. Because when you talk about high endurance workout athletes, or when you talk about strength and conditioning or weightlifting, it does involve a lot of energy. And I have mentioned this in my earlier videos as well, ki carbohydrates hamari body ka powerhouse hai. It is the powerhouse and the source of energy. So if you're not, you know, if you're neglecting carbohydrates from your meals, it's not the most ideal solution to, you know, scrutinize your body with the same amount of work as well. But again, if you're a common man who does not really get into a lot of workouts and has a regular life with a regular job, then this works great for your weight loss. It works great for your, you know, brain functions, works good for your acne and skin, works also good for your metabolisms per se, because kehte hai na loha lohe ko marta hai, fat ko katta hai. So crazy for weight loss. Now the second type of diet that I wanted to talk to you guys about is the hunter gatherers diet. Yes, you heard me right. जो हम स्टोन एज में खाते थे, जो हम स्टोन एज में किया करते थे, सेम काइंड ऑफ डाइट. नाउ देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल विद द सेम बिलीफ कि जिस स्पीड से, जिस रेट से हमारा सिविलाइजेशन ग्रो हुआ है, हमारी बॉडी, हमारा डीएनए, हमारा इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स, इंटरनल सिस्टम, उस स्पीड से, उस रेट से ग्रो नहीं हुआ. सो इवन टूडे दे फील दैट द बॉडी वुड रिएक्ट टू दैट काइंड ऑफ अ डाइट विच वी यूज टू हैव वाइल, you know, the caveman period or the stone age period, that will impact result and work the best for our body. So anything, any food that you can find while hunting and gathering, consider your fruits and vegetables, consider your lean meats, consider your seafood, you know, catching a fish here and there and eating it. Everything comes under paleo diet, because that is what people used to do back then. Catch something, heat it up and eat it. So any kind of processed stuff, any kind of processed carbs, processed sugars is a complete no-no here. So again, very similar to what we're going to discuss later, which is the weekend diet. Again, here you have no dairy products at all, because again, dairy products require farming and a lot of processed things happen and a lot of, you know, interference by man. But paleo diet is raw. So if you can get hands-on to paleo diet, if you guys can try it with the kind of workouts that you have, that'll be great. See for yourself if it's working out for you or not working out for you. Now, I don't know how much of a practical solution or a practical diet it is in today's time to eat raw foods, lean meats, fruits and vegetables. But again, depends on your lifestyle and your workout. So you guys will be the best judge for it. Now, the third diet that I want to talk to you guys about is the most famous, the most popular, which is the vegan diet. Yes. And veganism has become a thing, right? I mean, a lot of people are turning vegan. And more than that, more than being a lifestyle, it has become a way of life, I must say so. Because with veganism, there are a lot of values and belief system that is attached, you know, with people. Like some people want to keep the ecosystem intact, some people want to say no to cruelty to the animals, and some people want to work towards the climate change and so on and so forth. But this video is not about, you know, what I believe in or what other people believe in, XYZ things. But vegan diet is predominantly anything that has to do away from animals. Dairy products, keep it away. Meats, keep it away. Seafood, keep it away. So, jo bhi animal se aata hai, animal se banta hai, usko aap dur rakhiye. And that is a simple explanation of what a vegan diet is. Now, this is amazing for, again, weight loss purposes. It keeps you very light. Heart diseases ke liye ye best hai, because it keeps your cholesterol levels very, very low. So if you have a history of heart diseases, if you are under the risk of certain chronic diseases, aankh band karke choose this diet. Alright, again, my personal observation. And again, so this will not hamper your workouts per se, but what I wish and intend to say here is that your diets need to be complementing your workouts, your diets need to be complementing your lifestyle. आप मतलब डाइट के वजह से तुम अपना काम का रूटीन नहीं चेंज कर सकते, राइट? डाइट के वजह से तुम बार बार अपना जिम नहीं चेंज कर सकते या ट्रेनर नहीं चेंज कर सकते, राइट? सो डिपेंडिंग टू व्हाट योर वर्कआउट इज, डिपेंडिंग टू व्हाट योर गोल्स आर, व्हाट योर नीश इज, व्हाट योर लाइफस्टाइल इज, देन चूज द डाइट. ऑलराइट, एंड डाइट यस डस प्ले 70% ऑफ यू नो सिग्निफिकेंस इन योर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, बट द थॉट प्रोसेस हैज टू बी द अदर वे अराउंड, बिकॉज इट हैज टू कोइंसाइड विद योर लाइफस्टाइल. So the second most important thing before choosing a diet, it should be that, before choosing a diet, never try to fight your roots. So let's say, for example, if I am a Marwari, I come from Rajasthan, and I have been born and raised in a vegetarian family, my body is not going to accept meats. My body is not really going to accept, animal products. Because for generations, my family, my genes, my DNA, it has never really experienced what, you know, animal food looks like, tastes like, and reacts like. If I want to get into animal products or, you know, animal food, it might take decades or even a couple of generations or one generation at least for the body to acclimatize to the change. Same way, if you're from the coastal regions or if you're from, some parts of Rajasthan again, where red meat, lal mas is quite famous, coastal region seafood is quite famous, and, you know, it's a staple diet, do not try to fight that per se. So eat it in moderation if your belief system is not crashing, but that's a different debate altogether. But do not try to fight that because of transformation or fitness goals or, you know, workout related stuff. Alright guys, so these were your three lifestyle diets. Now if I am talking to you guys about lifestyle diets, how can I miss out on the most effective and the most popular fasting techniques? One of the fasting techniques that I personally have been following since past 6 months and has worked a great deal. Yes, I am talking about intermittent fasting, popularly known as IF. Now why is it so popular psychologically as well? Because it doesn't stop you from eating your favorite food. Yes, be it sugar, be it carbohydrates, be it anything, intermittent fasting does not stop you from eating any of those. The only thing that it asks you to do is choose an eating window and choose a fasting period. So the most, if you want to get the maximum results out of it, you have to keep your eating window anything below 9 hours. The best and the most effective windows would be your 8 hours and your 9 hours. Anything beyond 9 hours can just look like any other regular day. So let's say, for example, I keep my window as 9 hours, and the first meal that I have, or the first heavy substance apart from water that I have at 12 o'clock, is milk. Then I break my fast at around 12, which is afternoon, and then I have the next following 9 hours as my eating period, and I can eat till 9 p.m. and then I cannot indulge in any food, any liquids other than water. That is what is intermittent fasting. So it allows you to fast for 15 to 16 hours, have nothing other than water, and have anything you'd like for that 8 to 9 hours of your eating window. Now, what are the benefits that you see in this fasting technique is that it regulates your weight crazily. It doesn't really give you any mood swings. It doesn't affect your temper. It doesn't affect your, you know, energy levels and your performance level, none of that sorts. And it gives your body time to digest and utilize the nutrients, the food, everything in its optimum level. That is why it has been really popular since decades and is here to stay as well. Alright guys, again, I'd like to end this video by saying that yes, I'm not a certified nutritionist. These are all my observations and what I think should be done. But again, fitness is very subjective from one person to the other, from one goal to the other. And I really would like to see, you know, people try out different things to see what works out for them, what doesn't work out for them. And routine is the only thing that kills the body. So have a variety to your workouts, have a variety to your diets, and you will see amazing results for yourself. Cheers, guys. I hope you liked this video. I hope this video was a little informative. And if you liked it, so please stay tuned for more. Cheers.